Okay, the last thing, first batch yesterday they gave, right? So you have seen how the Arduino is able to do the controlling work. So the last class I drew the block diagram of Arduino, right? What are the things present in the Arduino? Yes? Yes? That is connecting the IoT communication device with the ULE. See, the Arduino is an extension of our microcontroller. Why this board is developed? What is the necessity of developing this board? See, whenever you are using a microcontroller, we have to connect external components, right? Resistors, capacitors, like that and all. We need to connect along with the, when you are doing an electronic project or anything, if your microcontroller is used, we have to connect externally last bench, the resistors, capacitors and all separately. So you know, since if there is some mistakes in that connection, automatically we have to check over the microcontroller connection also. So in order to avoid that, they have developed this Arduino board, which is nothing but an extension of microcontroller, which after this Arduino 328 they have developed, and they have developed as the board. Okay, so that means we need not connect any external components to this one, and it is a user friendly board for doing the electronic project. This Arduino board is used in most of the projects. If you see Kishore and Vijay Shepra, want to go, Rakesh want to go down. See, for the purpose is to develop the electronic projects, they have developed this code. Okay, and writing the programming code in Arduino is using C and C++. When you are using a microcontroller, what language you are using? Assembly language we are using, right? Yes, only microcontroller means only embedded C. When you are using, we are using the C language along with the microcontroller only, right? Yes or no? So in order to avoid that and all, here you can use only C and C++, okay, for doing projects. So programming language is also easy to write, okay, it is user friendly board. So just the commands which we are using, if you see, we are using the digital mode, okay, digital mode, which mode, which, okay, which mode means which pin you are using for seeing the output. Then we are writing digital write, and then we write digital read. Okay, digital write is used for writing, that means inputs, okay, and digital read we are using for reading the output. So pins, okay, digital pin, or you can write pin mode, pin mode, which mode you are using this one. See, it is user friendly, small small mistakes and all, it does not take it. why it is provided. See, certain times, so in the board we would have loaded so many programs. So in order to reset and clear the programs, we can use the reset bits. Okay, so that is another thing. And using the USB connector also we can do the power supply. And whenever we are connected to USB connector, it is connected along with the computer, right? So we have to see the port number of that particular USB. Okay, if we are, that is the tool part of this Arduino. Tool we have to remember. So the first batch knows that. Second batch this way. I'll show the what next one. So you can just know before. Just if you remove the board connection, that means USB cable, the board connection will not be shown in the computer. Once we plug the USB cable from the computer to the UNA board, it will show the port, the cable port which it is connected, USB cable port. That we have to connect accordingly. And there are a lot of Arduino boards. Okay, there are a lot of Arduino boards. So using that the boards, if you see any board, whichever board which you are using, that also we have to choose it. All the Arduino boards will be visible in the choosing of the boards. So whichever we are using, we have to particularly choose. So if we are using UNA, we are using UNA Arduino UNO. Okay, if you are using other lily pad or other things, okay, that means if you are connecting in the tool part, the other part means it will not work. So before doing everything, the configuration, that is only tool configuration and port configuration, we have to particularly do to interface Arduino board along with the computer. So the wireless devices, Bluetooth, can be downloaded either in the system or in your computer, in your phone, mobile phone. Okay, everything together only can act as an IoT device. Okay, so our syllabus they have given in the lab, because based on the theory only, the lab syllabus is given. So IoT device controlling using Zigbee, Bluetooth, and they have given on one more GSM. So using one each one, we have to write it. Are you able to follow? Yes. So only here it is, since it is wireless, we are using only the pins, right? That means the connectors alone, jumper pins alone, to do this connection. Automatically, the wireless connections will be able to get it, because it's wireless, right? Just that alone, we have to do it. So what is the first thing whenever you are doing a board thing? We are just doing a compiling, that is to check an error on the program. Yes. After the program is right, we have to onboard that board, right? The program has to be loaded. So we have to load the program. Whenever we are getting an error in the program, the transmitter and receiver pin should be removed. After uploading, we have to connect to the transmitter and receiver pins. And then we have to connect the devices. Okay. After uploading, when we have a trouble in uploading the program, then we have to remove the transmitter and receiver pin from the UNO. And then we have to upload it in the system. And then we have to connect the UNA with the transmitter and receiver pins. Okay. So once if it is connected, the transmitter and the receiver pins, okay, then automatically we can control over the device using that thing. So whenever we are using a wireless devices, it has to be paired with the hardware also, right? So once it is not paired, we cannot send any message, right? Anything, you cannot do any control over of anything. So first it has to be paired with the device. That means the IoT device which we are keeping as mobile phone. Okay. So that should be paired with the device, and as per the instruction given, it will execute, that means it will control that device. You can switch on and off light fan or anything, you can do it like that. So by giving a high cable or using DC power. The reset button is there, and then we have the microcontroller there. Then we have the analog pins, digital pins, pulse width modulation. In the diagram, what you have seen.